Hey everybody and welcome back to the garden. One day this summer I was sitting outside here on my porch just minding my own business and guess what I found on that post right there. Well, here is the assassin bug. It looks scary, doesn't it? Now it's also known as a wheel bug because if you look at its back you'll see the hump that actually looks like a saw blade. You want to use caution. Don't try to handle these things because they do have a painful bite, and some people might actually be allergic. Now, you're going to find these from June through September, so when I found him, I started being on the lookout for him. And like all insects, this assassin has 6 jointed legs, 2 antennae, and an exoskeleton that's made of chitin, which is actually the same material that forms our hair and fingernails. I thought that was pretty cool. And if you look at, they have a 3-part body, consists of the head with the mouth parts and a beak, and they stab their prey with the beak, and they have eyes and antennae. They have a thorax where the legs and the wings attach, and they have the abdomen with reproductive and digestive organs. So I found out there's a whole lot of different species of the assassin bugs around the whole world, and they live in lots of different habitats. And they do range from Europe to Africa to North, Central, and South America. And in some places in the world, they call them kissing bugs because they bite people near the mouth. Now these right here have been found in Georgia. And I did find out that there's over 100 types of these assassins that live here in North America. And they look pretty vicious, but they're actually very beneficial. They eat lots of non-beneficial insects that are pests to farmers and gardeners. Now, they are an aggressive bug, and they are not afraid to attack creatures larger than themselves. And if food is scarce, they'll even eat other assassin bugs. And they love beetles, mosquitoes, flies, and large caterpillars. So I'm going to put this one in my garden in hopes that he'll find that big old tomato hornworm that's eating my tomatoes. I did find out that because they're such good predators, the scientists in California are very interested in using them as a natural control agent for crop pests. Now right here, he seems a little agitated and it looks like he's raising that wheel up a little bit on his back. Assassins get their name because of their predatory style. They lie in wait for other insects and then they attack it and they stab it. And they inject a toxin that actually dissolves the tissues, and the assassin sucks out those tissues. Gross. Their beak is 3-segmented instead of 4, and most bugs in the Hemiptera order do have 4-segmented beaks. Their genus and species is Arilus cristatus. It is in the Hemiptera order, so it's kin to like stink bugs and stuff like that. And the females only lay a little cluster of eggs in a sheltered spot, like in the shade or under rocks and in some cracks of trees. But they only have a generation per year, and the eggs will overwinter until next June, and those nymphs will emerge about 2 months before they morph into an adult. And y'all, even though these bugs do have a nasty bite, they are important and they will help to keep the insect populations balanced. And yikes, these things look scary.
Okay, y'all, I hope you learned a little bit about the assassin bug. And maybe next time you find one in your yard, you'll put it in your garden. So I appreciate you watching and we will see you here next time back at the garden.